Hello everyone and welcome to another technical analysis update. My name's Craig Earle, I'm a market analyst here at Alpari. Today I'm going to not take a look at every currency pair. I'm just going to basically focus on things I've been looking at this week. Not every currency has had a huge amount of volatility. A lot of them have, to be fair, especially compared to the last few weeks. But there's certain ones which in my eyes have looked better than others. Apologies if I don't cover anything which you guys are covering. But I'm basically just going to go over some of the ones which I've been paying most attention to, look at the week, focus on the weekly and daily really, and maybe a touch of the 4 hour, because these are the most relevant really going into the weekend. Let's see how the week shaped up, what it means going forward. First things first, let's do this quick risk warning. Basically all it's saying is any views expressed here are my own. It's not investment advice, should not be taken that way, and they are also not the views of Alpari UK, purely my views, not investment advice. With that out of the way, time to look at the charts. Euro dollar, again, well, I say whether we're going to look at things with the most volatility. It's not been the most volatile, but let's be honest. Euro dollar, cable dollar yen, these are the three most traded currency pairs out there, so I'm never really going to not touch on them. And euro dollar, actually, while it's not had a huge amount of volatility, there has been a few significant things happen this week. Firstly, we've had the completion of this double top. This is something which I said it had to fall back towards 134 to be completed and hit its target, which is, of course, is generated based on the size of the double top, then projected low below the neckline. We hit that target eventually, even though it was showing signs that it was going to be easing up. The 200 DMA, the 200 week SMA was providing a lot of support, but as I've mentioned previously on a number of occasions, we've seen this 200 week SMA breached, but the closing levels have failed to close below or above them on these occasions, and it looks like that's what's going to happen again, because we've seen a lot of strength in euro dollar towards the end of the week, to the point when it looks as though we're actually going to get a closing candle above the 200 week SMA. Now, whether that means we're going to see whether that's just temporary, or whether that actually means we're going to see a little bit of strength in the next week or two, we'll have to see how things get underway on Monday. But for me, that would suggest that we're going to see a little bit of strength maybe at the start of next week in this euro dollar pair. One other thing to highlight was the fact, again, we highlighted it before, 7.2368, or there or thereabouts anyway, on the stochastic. You can see that every time it's reached this level, it's rebounded higher. It was at this level again, and now it looks like it's potentially going to turn higher. Now, this wasn't just recently. This is looking back all the way to 2007. We had a brief breach of this level there, but you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 occasions prior to this, since that previous breach, every time it's reached this level, it's rebounded higher. History does tend to repeat itself. Well, that is effectively what technical analysis is. We're saying that history tends to repeat itself, and it looks as though it's going to do that again. We are seeing it at this level, but it looks like it's now rebounding higher. The daily chart really does support this view. We've got a really bullish candle today. We had the warning signs, I should say, and this is something I've highlighted on previous videos and also in previous webinars. Lower lows being made on the price action, higher lows being made on the stochastic. Bullish divergence would suggest that we're going to see a push higher. Loss of momentum as part of this move to the downside as we move back down to the 50 Fib level here, which is highlighted as well on the weekly chart. Brilliant support there. Also hitting that target from the double top as well, fell nicely in line. So we've hit the 50 Fib and now we're starting to bounce higher. We had the warning of the bullish divergence as well. When we see the bullish divergence form on what's expected to be a key support level, I think that's a really real strong signal, and that's how it's turned out to be on this occasion. Like I say, the big level now for me is probably going to be this 135 level, big round number. We've breached 134 already. The descending trend line should provide some resistance at this level as well, previous level of support. I think this is going to be the initial target. It's going to be the big test anyway. It's going to be the big resistance level. It wouldn't surprise me if we see it reach that 135 before pulling lower. Let's see what Fib levels we've got around this level. We've got the 38.2 Fib level coming in around this level as well. So a couple of key levels to keep an eye on there in the coming week. Cable, this week we've seen a breach of that ascending trend line, so it's been a significant week here. I added this initial Fib to see if we were going to see it hold up around any of these levels, but we've seen such strong selling. This is two very bearish candles, assuming that we don't see a massive rally right at the end of this week. Breached all the Fib levels, which suggests that the correction we're going to see is going to be much more significant. Now, naturally, I will just pull back to this next level to see how we react at this levels. do not be surprised if we see a much bigger correction. I'm not saying we're necessarily going to see a pullback or quite as big as this, but I also wouldn't be surprised, if I'm perfectly honest. It's been such a strong rally in the cable pair recently that I wouldn't be surprised to see a much bigger correction. But for now, I'll probably be keeping an eye on these big fib levels. So 167.20, 166 being the next two on the 50 fib and the 61.8. 50 fib also coincides with those previous lows as well, which is always nice. Just provides additional support for this this potential support level to come. But like I say, two very bearish weeks, not really seeing any indication as to why that trend had changed. We may see a bit of bullishness next week, but that's not unusual when you see such a bearish candle. This is almost a Marabozu candle. Sometimes what you'll see is you'll see a bit of a rally in the next week, rallying up to around the 50% level of the Marabozu candle, which is otherwise known as the Marabozu line, before running into resistance. As long as we don't get a close above this level, then that's seen as fairly bearish. On the daily chart, really just confirming this, we've got four bearish days. We've broken through a lot of big moving averages, the 20, the 50, the 100 simple moving day simple moving average. Haven't yet approached the 200 day simple moving average. That could be a big support level to come. We haven't traded below the 200 day simple moving average for a year. So good timing. We've traded above that moving average for a year. Been a very strong rally. Long overdue, this correction in my eyes. We did have the warning signs, I should highlight again. This is something we highlighted on previous videos. I am a big fan of divergences. We had the negative divergence here with the MACD histogram showing a loss of momentum while price action was making higher highs. And then we had further divergence here with lower highs being made on the stochastic at a time when the price action was still making higher highs. So we did have the warning signs. They were there again. And they were at a... So, I mean, well, like I say, for me, the warning signs were there. We had the break of the trend line, which then went on to confirm it as well. But I think we are still going to see some more bearish moves. May see a little bit of strength at the early part of next week, though, because we have seen two very very bearish weeks. Dollar yen's starting to look up, thank God. We've been trapped really between the 50-week SMA and the 20-week SMA over the last month or so. The trading range has been getting smaller and smaller, but it looks like we've broken above that trading range. Not only that, we've broken above the descending trend line, which goes back to the end of last year. So it looks like we are seeing a little bit of activity now in this pair. We were seeing two big resistance and two big support levels really here for quite a little while. We had 101.30, which was providing significant support. We were seeing occasional breakthroughs on the day, but more often than not, we were seeing these levels close back above it the same day, if not the day after. The big support below that tended to be 175. To the upside, it was 102.70. Again, most days we'd made some trading above it, bar these two occasions, but they were fundamentally driven. But then quite often they'd end the day, or at least move back below the next day. The next level above that was 103. You can see that this was a previous test here. That's proven to be resistance again, but you can see that today that descending trend line has provided support. That for me is a bit of confirmation of the move higher. I'm curious to see if that was a fib level. Perfect 38.2 fib level, 102.31, bouncing off the fib level, off the descending trend line. For me, that's a bit of confirmation of the break high. We may now start to see a push to the upside. We are in overbought territory on the stochastic, and we have seen a cross, which may actually hint at the opposite. But one thing we should always remember is that we can stay overbought for quite a while before we start to see a move, especially when we've just come from a period of consolidation as well. Things go overbought and oversold extremely quickly. So while it's worth keeping there's a red flag, while it's worth paying attention to it, sorry, as a red flag, it's not necessarily a sell signal all on its own. Looking a little bit more bullish. Let's see how the actual price action reacted at that level. Moving down the chart, it's still, even when you move down, it's looking, that's quite a significant reaction. There's no point in going down too far, given that we're looking at daily and weekly charts. But let's see how the day ends. Let's see how much, if we can get a rally into the end of the day, for example, maybe that's going to be a bit more of a bullish sign. If not, if we end towards closer towards the day's lows, then maybe that would suggest that we're going to see a pullback to the 50 fib, maybe even a 200 day simple moving average as well. But that 38.2 does line up nicely with those two previous levels of resistance. Moving along now, let's take a look at gold. We've seen some nice moves in gold today off the back of that US jobs report. We saw a rally today off those 1280 lows, which we reached once again. We haven't seen those lows actually reached, I should highlight, for about 4 or 5 weeks now, but we have seen it rally off those lows, those 1280 lows. 61.8 Fibonacci retracement, I should say, as well, from the 3rd of June lows to the 10th of July highs. We did see it bounce off that before running higher. Then we're looking at closer levels. We saw it rally up towards the 50 fib level here. That was from these highs in the short, because you can see we're in a short-term downtrend. So taking the swing highs of from the 29th of July down to the swing lows on the 1st of August, we saw it rally up to that 50 fib level around just below that 1300 mark before starting to pull back. For me, this is still bearish because we're still making lower highs and lower lows in the long term, but I am cautious about the fact that we've bounced off that 61.8. so for me, what I really need to see right now, if I'm perfectly honest, is either a break of that 61.8 fib level, or I need to see a break of these previous highs, so the highs of 1312. A break of one of those will confirm to me what the next move is. In the short term, it's still looking bearish. You could still see another move back towards a 61.8 fib level. In the longer term, potentially still looking a little bit more bullish. Another one, nice one this week, has been crude, and this is the one I'm going to wrap things up on. Crude has been one of those this week that's been reliable for volatility, and I know we've talked a lot about volatility recently. There's not been a huge amount of volatility in many of the currency pairs. There's still been plenty in some, you just got to look around for it, I guess. But crude has been one of those more reliable sources of volatility, and as you can see, there's been a lot of some quite big moves in crude recently. We can see it very clearly in a longer term uptrend, but then the shorter term trend has been a little bit more bearish, lower highs, lower lows. This is another one, in my opinion, that tends to be quite good for using Fibonacci retracement levels. You can see 103.03 here ended up being quite a nice little resistance level. I haven't checked to see whether this provided a good target. It wasn't the best in this case, but we've got the ascending trend line here in the longer term trend line here. That was the trend line which I highlighted going back to the week of the 24th of June 2012 lows. We are fast approaching this now. This is going to be a big level now for crude. If we can see a break below here, it would suggest that we're going to see a more significant move to the downside. Big level coming in then around that 92 level. So that's a big drop off really if we do see a break below that trend line. But you can see that anytime we've traded in these 90 ranges, they tend to have been very strong, aggressive moves, not too much time spent trading around that middle region. So this really is quite a big, significant level of support. Aside from that, we've also got this previous low as well, which is clearly providing some support as well for crude as well. So in the long term, this is a massive level for crude. It wouldn't surprise me if we see a move to the upside. If we do, then you could potentially see this 98.10 provide resistance, as we've already seen actually today. But I think crude as well, looking at longer term, crude has been great for intraday as well. Look at the intraday charts have been really great for crude, especially, like I said, at a time when others haven't necessarily been as good. Been great price action on crudes. If anyone's looking for anywhere for good volatility, good intraday volatility, then crude is one that I would certainly recommend at the moment. Okay, I think I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you very much for joining us. Join us again on Monday. I'll do a big look at the week ahead, take a look at a lot more currency pairs. Don't forget, on Tuesday, we've also got the webinar when we take a look at about 10 or 15 currency pairs, 4 or 5 indices, and also a few commodities as well. So don't forget to join us for that. That's 12:30 till 1:30 on Tuesday. The recording will be up about an hour or so after that, and that is with I think that'll be with myself, Josh, and Phil on Tuesday. And the sign-up link for that is on the newsroom, alpari.co.uk/newsroom. You can also go to alpari.co.uk/education/webinars. Aside from that, I think that's pretty much everything. Have a great weekend, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this week, and I hope to see you again next week. Thank you.